money spender, aren't you? A dollar? Jeez, Gab, dig deep. Raiden Parr out there in the 71 car and Jordyn Charge into number 60. And tell you, when you look at the cars still to come, Sammy Walsh has half a chance to beat quick time out of this.
Sammy's very close. Just waiting for Braden Parr on the Western Oil 71 to fire.
Not firing at the moment. This car is actually a car, I believe, that is it Molly, that ran earlier in the year in the States with the Triple X, the Western Oil entry. It's not firing. This will be Adrian with a big frown on his face. It will not fire. David Murcott was working on the Magneto on this car. I did tap him on the shoulder and say, Murky, if it doesn't fire, we're going to look towards you. But I was only kidding at the time.
I need some magic about that one for sure. How cool was it to see Jordyn Charge race with you in Belmoline Raceway as a 16-year-old? His birthday was
the day after it turned
a little bit earlier, being 24 hours. And then on the Tuesday, went and got his learner's permit just so he can sit with his, it's not right really, as an elder person to actually drive on the road. But, you know, on Saturday night, 16 years and I'm racing a 100 horsepower sprint car in Sydney.
He actually made it into the show and he rolled over, but not through any fault of his own. Car spun in front of him, he had nowhere to go and he rolled over. But made a very, very smooth little cat. Keep your eye on that car.
There's just a word wave coming through. Matt Dumpsey, I know you've just sat down, Matty, but they want you back in your car. Matt Dumpsey, you can head straight back to your car.
Oh, man, that's going to be the way far. Somewhere in the first three rows. Nice job so far. Jordyn Charge. The Sammy Walsh workers line to Charge and break.